At the time of this recording, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi had just finished her speech on the economy. For those of you who have been watching the latest Obama ads blaming Bush and McCain for the economy, check the records. One of the hallmarks of the Clinton administration was his legislation to make it easier for minorities to afford to buy a house. Bill Clinton has also admitted to this being the Democrats' fault, citing along with Clinton's own urging of the Democrats to vote for McCain's bill in 2005 to tighten up Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. It never got out of committee. Who opposed it? You betcha. It was Barack Hussein Obama. While Obama has been going off in his ads saying he is the victim of lies by the McCain campaign, it was Obama that had taken the second highest contributions from Fannie Mae, where Obama owed the biggest favors, and like most politicians groomed by the Chicago Daily Political Machine, he took the money and delivered, selling us out, the citizens of America. Don't buy it from him, America. This man is playing you. He is a socialist, so he would like nothing more than to crush our capitalism into socialist collective nation. Don't think for a second he wouldn't. Just look at his background, his friends, and his hateful, mean-spirited, anti-white, anti-American wife, Michelle. They attend a church where a raving maniac goes off talking about hating white people all day. If you don't think so, read her Princeton thesis, and it is no wonder Barack Obama tried to keep it from the public. This is a man who wouldn't help an unwanted baby, the survivor of a failed abortion. He is that cold-hearted. I couldn't see anyone doing that to a puppy, much less a human infant. Shame on you, Barack Obama. Shame on you for your bogus Christianity of black liberation theology that so resembles the hatred we see from Islamic Muslim extremists. You want change, Mr. Obama? How about changing yourself and we will all be better off? You can start by quitting your lies about a true American, someone who doesn't have to prove his patriotism or his loyalty to his country, someone who doesn't have to prove he has the courage to go to the distance, even when the distance is 4 extra years of suffering at the hands of his captors when he could have left early. Now it is us, the American people, that are captured. The captive audience of an irresponsible mainstream media so far to the left, I rarely watch television, and it is off during The View. The only view they have is tunnel vision, then David the duped Letterman and Wolf the sheep Blitzer. Obama has captured many of the hearts of Americans, but I know a hallmark of all great con artists is the uncanny ability to get people to like them before he cons them. Barack, you might have fooled them, but I'm from Chicago, and I know what you're about. And as bad as anyone might think of Republican opponent John McCain, frankly, Barack, when it comes to all the things a great American leader is made of, you, sir, couldn't fill John McCain's jockstrap. But that tranny-looking wife of yours might. America, we face rough times, and I know America has not been herself for many years. 8 to be exact. This is going to take a miracle and the Lord and his angels, so to help, I won't give up if you don't give up.
I need a sign to let me know you're here. All of these lines are being crossed over the atmosphere.